There's nothing like a Christmas tune to bring on the holiday spirit, especially some Paul Kelly Christmas magic. No mention of reindeer, holly or snow in this quintessentially Australian Christmas album called Christmas Train. 22 extraordinary songs, and I'm very happy to say Paul Kelly joins us now live from Melbourne. G'day, Paul.
Hi, Angela. How are you going?
We are great. Thank you so much for this album. This is just what we need. 22 awesome, a really eclectic mix of songs. How did you pick them?
Oh, I've been sort of picking them slowly over the years, just building up to it. I love all the great range of Christmas music. Sometimes we forget what variety that there is across the classical world, the choral world, folk music, gospel music, music from other cultures. So I've been building up a little playlist of my own over the years, and then I started, you know, picking songs and then matching them with different singers. Then we sort of set up the band in the studio and invited the different singers to come in and sing with us.
And what a bunch of contributors you've got. Of course, you've got Vicar and Linda Bull. You've got beautiful Casey Chambers. You've even got Channel 10's own Waleed Ali. Tell me some of the other people you've got on board.
We've got Leo. Did you mention Marlon Williams? Does a beautiful version of Oh Holy Night, and he sings it in Te Reo Māori, and that's a real highlight for me of the record. Alice Keith and Simon Nugent, they were singing Silent Night with me before that you were playing. Yeah, lots of different people, just to give all that colour and richness to the record. Emma Donovan, stunning version of Virgin Mary Have One Son, an old gospel song. Yeah.
Just incredible. And we've got a sparkling new version of, a Christmas classic, your very own How to Make Gravy. Let's have a listen.
I guess the brothers are driving down from Queensland. Stella's flying in from the coast. They say it's gonna be 100 degrees, even more maybe.
Five years old, that song, it's hard to believe. And tell me about this new clip.
Well, director Sian Darling, it was her idea to put out a call on our social pages and just ask people to film themselves just on their phones or however, singing along or doing something to the new recording of the song. And then we sent them the recording, and then we got a great response. Lots of people sent in stuff, and Sian, the director, she cut it all together. It's got a lot of emotional power.
It does. I got a bit teary watching it because some people are holding up messages, obviously, for people they haven't been able to see from COVID and so forth. Gorgeous. Yeah. Now, you're also getting to play live again now. Have you done your first gigs yet?
We did two shows in Melbourne, a first shows in Melbourne for 2 years last week at the Maya Music Bowl. And, it was just like I was saying about the clip. It's very emotional. Yeah. The audience was emotional. You could feel it, and we were on stage, and we're used to people singing along at the shows, but I don't think I've ever heard a crowd sing louder. It was sort of coming back at us really strongly.
That
people
is incredible.
People in a really great mood. Yeah.
And you've got some special Making Gravy concerts next week, I think. And also, a very special one on Gravy Day that's in Melbourne on next Tuesday, the 21st, of course, which is Gravy Day here in Australia. And we can all watch that. We can stream it. Is that right?
Yeah, we recorded the second Melbourne show, and that's now it'll be available. You know, we'll stream it for, I think, 24 hours on December the 21st.
And people in Brisbane, though, can see you live on Saturday the 18th.
That's right. That's Brisbane on the 18th, and we get up to Sandstone Point a bit further north on the 19th. And that's this year. And then we get around all over the place next year. A lot of the shows that we couldn't get to do this year, we've postponed. We'll be in Sydney in March, and we'll be in Waimea Adelaide, and Byron Bay Blues Fest, and lots of regional shows as well all around the country.
Oh, brilliant. And what's in store for Christmas for you?
Our big Christmas, our big family Christmas, we celebrate on Christmas Eve, singing carols and getting together. Everyone brings a plate. So with my brothers and sisters and their children and our children and our children's children. So we'll have three generations. It sort of moves around from place to place. It's my place this year, so we'll probably have about 30 people in the backyard.
Well, you better get started working hard and making the gravy. Paul Kelly, it's been great chatting to you. Head to paulkelly.com.au to check out the Christmas Train album. And if you're in Brisbane and you'd like to go to Paul Kelly's Making Gravy at River Stage, head to frontiertouring.com for tickets. It's been great to catch up with you. Have a lovely Christmas.
You too, Angela, and everybody. Have a great Christmas and New Year. See you later.